Who is that prophet of Deuteronomy 18? I'm going to give you 20 proofs. I could put them as questions. I could have a little fun, take a little longer. Is this Jesus Christ or is this a man? Now, if it's a man, that doesn't mean we're going to know when he works. We're going to have to figure out when he carries out the restitution of all things. But our first question is, who is it? So that strongly suggests God is going to work through another man like he did Moses. And the Lord said to me, they've well spoken, I will raise up a prophet. This is God saying, I'll raise up someone who looks like you. So point number one would suggest it's a man. But maybe it's Christ one time calling himself a prophet. Maybe. I mean, certainly I believe that for 50 years. It's got to be a viable possibility. To remember that, I was setting you up, brethren, a couple weeks ago. Who else could speak and every last soul on earth would hear what he said? And if they didn't do it, billions of people, they would be destroyed. And destroyed is a very strong word there. It literally means ripped out of mankind. Now look, brethren, here's who that prophet is. There are no other possibilities. He is Elijah the prophet. Anybody who doesn't want to believe all these verses really should just go on out. Anybody who looks at all these verses, they're not vague, they're not few, they're not cloudy, they're crystal clear and says, I don't believe it because Mr. Armstrong didn't teach it or whatever they say. Crazy ideas, just dumb stuff. That they're not converted and they don't belong in the church. They should move on. They were tares. Although if they disrespect me, they disrespect God. I'll